Retouching is a foundational skill of photo editing, and in this video, we will cover the basics of retouching with blemish removal and even how to naturally smooth skin. If there is one thing I wanted you to take away from this video, it is the importance of a non-destructive workflow when it comes to retouching. So basically all that means is we don't want to mess up this background photo at all. We want to do everything on their own separate layers. Now, one way of doing this is just by hitting Ctrl J on your background layer, and that will create a duplicate so that you can do everything from there. But for this video, when we're doing blemish removal, I think the better way of doing that is to come down and hit new pixel layer, and that will create a new pixel layer above it. And then what we're going to do is use the healing brush tool over here. So with that tool, to make this a non-destructive workflow, all we have to do is come up to source and make sure that current layer and below is selected and not just current layer. And so now we can use this tool on the new pixel layer that we created instead of our background photo layer. So now I'm just gonna zoom into this photo by holding down Control and then using my mouse wheel. A quick little tip when it comes to retouching is you don't really wanna zoom in all the way when you're doing it. You wanna make sure that you stay a little bit back. And that is just because if you're zoomed all the way in, you might try and edit out some texture in the skin that you really don't have to do. So it's better to stay at least a little bit zoomed out when you're zooming in. Now, as another quick little tip before we go on to actually retouching this photo, something I like to do is come into the adjustments. So if you have the adjustment panel open, you can come into there. Otherwise, down in your layer panel, you'll see the adjustment button right here. So come into your adjustments, and then all we're going to do is add a black and white adjustment layer. And with this open, you just want to drag down the reds quite a bit. Now, as you can see, what this does is it brings out the red a little bit more in the photo. So basically all of the blemishes that are on this person's skin are going to show through as darkness on here as a black and white layer. So now with that pixel layer selected that we made, I'm actually going to rename it just really quick, just to blemish, just to stay organized. And now with that healing brush tool selected, making sure that I'm on current layer and below, we can just go through and start retouching this photo. And to do that, all you have to do is hold down Alt or Option, and then click on a part of the skin that doesn't have any blemishes, and then you can use the bracket keys on your keyboard to adjust the size of the brush that you are working with here. So you just want to select a piece of skin, and then we're going to select a brush that is just ever so slightly bigger than the blemish that we are trying to remove, and then you can just click and drag to paint over, and that will replace that part of the skin with the part that you selected with Alt or Option. So then we can go through all of this and actually edit out all of the blemishes on this person's skin. However, one thing I want to mention is that you don't want to remove anything that is actually going to be permanent on that person's face. So for example, with this portrait here, she actually has a few different moles on here, like on her neck and along her cheek. And those are basically permanent features on a person's face that makes them who they are. And your entire goal with retouching should not be to change who the person is, but instead just to enhance how they look in the photo. So then we can go through and we can toggle the visibility of our black and white layer just to make sure that what we are removing is not a permanent feature of this person's face. And now I want to say for larger areas like this, what we can actually do is come back into our tool panel here and we can come down to the patch tool. And then with the patch tool selected, just like before, we want to come up to the source and make sure current layer and below is selected. Then we can click and drag over a larger area of the skin that we want to adjust. And then you'll see as we move our mouse around here, it will actually replace that part of the skin with wherever we end up clicking. So you want to make sure you select a part of the skin that is clean and is pretty close to the part where you're trying to replace. That way the skin texture looks pretty similar. All I have to do is come over and click on an area of the skin that I want. Then if you click again, you'll see that it gets applied to that area. So we can actually see the before and the after of what we're doing there. And some of the edges here look a little weird, but we can actually fix that with the healing brush tool as well. So I'm just gonna make sure I select some of these larger parts here and get those done first, just like this. The way I kind of like to think about retouching is you wanna get the larger parts first, kind of like how you would do the large brush strokes in a painting before you move on to the smaller details, just like that. And then of course you can always toggle the visibility of your black and white layer to see how things are going. As you can see with this one, it might be a little hard to tell, but if you look, the skin texture looks a little weird on that part. So I'm actually gonna hit Control Z on that one, and I'm gonna select a better part of the skin that might end up fitting there a little bit better. Just like that. So now that we've gotten the larger blemishes that we needed to remove, Now we can come back into the healing brush tool over here and then make sure we select a part that is clean. And then of course, just start painting over the parts that we need to replace, just like that. So I'm gonna go through and go ahead and do that, and I will show you the finished results once I am done. And so now I've gone through and taken away all the blemishes that needed to be removed. So you can actually see the before and the after of everything that we've done there. So now we have some pretty clear skin here. Now another thing with the blemish removal tool that we can do is you'll see that this vein is actually pretty distracting, I find. So something we can do is select a part of the eye that doesn't have that distracting vein on there. And then we can just paint over that vein. And then as you'll see, I kind of messed up here because I have a little bit of the eyelash coming through. So I'm just gonna hit Control Z on that and adjust the size of my brush. And we will just paint over that and basically just get rid of it to make it less distracting. So now you can see the before and the after of everything that we've done there. So now, in terms of actually smoothing out the person's skin, this person actually already has some really smooth skin. So I'm actually gonna show you on a different photo here. So with this photo, I've already gone through and done some retouching in terms of removing all the major blemishes from her skin. So you can see the before and the after of what I've done there. She already has some pretty good skin here, but we can definitely take it to the next level. So this is actually my blemish layer, which I forgot to name. Make sure you stay organized. Now, the tool that we're going to use to actually smooth out the skin is going to be something called frequency separation. And now what that is going to do is it is going to separate the skin texture from the skin color. And that way we can smooth out the skin while still keeping the texture of it and make it look very natural. So to do that, all we're going to do is with our blemish layer selected here, we're going to press Control or Command, Alter Option, and then Shift E. And then what that is going to do is create a new pixel layer based off of the layers that we had below it. And then I'm just gonna zoom all the way back out with Control Zero. And then with this new pixel layer selected, we're gonna come up to Filter and then Frequency Separation. And then you're gonna wanna zoom into the skin texture with the Control and Zoom wheel. And what I like to do with this is you'll take the radius slider here and bring it all the way to the left. And then from there, you just wanna take it and slowly bring it over until you have your skin texture on the left here and you can't really see any texture on the right. So you'll see as I bring this over, we just wanna get rid of that skin texture. So right about there. So we can't really see much skin texture in there, but we can see it on the left here. Then all you have to do is come over and hit apply, and that will create a high frequency and low frequency layer. So the high frequency is actually gonna be our skin texture, while the low frequency is going to be our skin color. And so we want to do all of the work that we're about to do in the low frequency layer. So with the low frequency layer selected, we're gonna come over and then select the freehand selection tool. And then before you start making a selection, you wanna make sure you have a pretty good feather here. And it might take some adjusting once you actually start doing it, but for this photo, I know that around 100 pixels is gonna work pretty well. Now for this technique, it usually works best around highlights. So I'm gonna start by selecting some of the main highlights of this person's skin. So like this area over here is catching the light a little bit better than some of the other areas. So then with our selection here, we can come up to Filter, and then Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. And now with this Gaussian Blur, we're gonna wanna do the same thing like we did for the frequency separation, by bringing the radius all the way down to zero. And then as we bring this over, it might be hard to see because this is a very subtle effect, but we are essentially smoothing the skin out. And it usually takes quite a bit for it to actually smooth out like that. So we can hit apply. And then to get rid of the marching ants, just hit Control or Command D. And then you can see exactly what we did there. So if you wanna be able to see a before and after, you just wanna control click on the high and low frequencies so that both of them are selected. And then you can hit Control or Command G, and that will put them in a group. And then we can rename the group. I usually just like to do FS for frequency separation. And then we can open that group and we can see that we have our high frequency and low frequency. And so if you wanna see the before and after, all we have to do is toggle the visibility of the group. It's a very subtle effect, but you can see that we are sort of smoothing out the skin there. And it still looks very natural because we can still see her skin texture. So we'll come back into that low frequency layer. With our freehand selection brush, we're just gonna click and drag over another highlight of the skin, Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur, and then we're just gonna repeat it again until we get something that we like, just like that. Hit Control or Command D to hide that, And then you just want to go through and basically do that with all the major highlight parts of the person's skin. And then I think we're going to have the biggest effect here on the forehead. So you want to select all of this up here. Then filter, blur, Gaussian blur. And then we can blur out the color here, but we can keep that texture. Just like that. And I think that area you can see before and after pretty well. So I'm just going to go through and do that with the rest of the major highlights here. And so I've gone through now and done all of the major highlights here. So you can see the before and the after of what I've done there. So now we can start making selections around the shadowy areas or even the midtones, and we can just go through the same process. We'll come up and then select Gaussian blur. We'll adjust it until we get something that we like. And the reason I like doing it this way, where you do the highlights and then the shadows, because the highlights are usually going to be the part that makes the skin look like really oily and just less attractive. So if you come in and do those first, then it basically gets you most of the way there before you get into like the shadows to really bring it that extra step. So now we're pretty much done here. I'm just kind of making sure that there's no other areas that would really benefit from blurring out the skin like this. I think most of our work here is pretty much done, but we'll just go through a few other smaller areas to make sure that we're making it look good and natural and still smoothing it out like that. And again, I think it's important to say that subtlety is key here. You really don't want to go and select a massive area like this. It could end up working just fine, but for most kind of closer up photos like this, where there's actually a lot of texture that you can see, it's better to just do some of the brighter parts and some of the darker parts, and then some areas that you know would benefit from it. And the more you do this, then the more practice you get out of it, the better you'll get with it as well, and you'll recognize the areas that would really benefit most from it. So be sure to practice this as much as you can, and I promise you'll get a lot better at it, and you'll get some really good looking results. But thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you have a great day. See ya.